From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Supporters of the effort in Portland to allow non-U.S. citizens who are in the country legally to vote are now waiting to see if they have enough signatures to get the issue on the November ballot. Members of the League of Young Voters turned in an additional 521 signatures this afternoon to the city clerk's office. That's after they found out last month that they were about 300 signatures short. The city clerk has 5 days to verify the signatures. The proposed charter amendment would allow legal immigrants to register to vote in municipal elections. However, they would not be allowed to vote on state and national issues. An update tonight on the fire truck crash in Shapley that sent a firefighter to the hospital yesterday. Shapley's fire chief says it will be at least 8 months before the town gets another fire truck to replace the one that was totaled in yesterday's crash. Officials say Captain Natasha Kinney was returning to the station after a call when she lost control of the fire engine and rolled over. Crews had to cut Kinney out of the wreckage. She is back home tonight, recovering from her injuries. The fire chief says he's made arrangements with the fire chiefs in the towns of Acton and Newfield to provide coverage in Shapley until they can get a new truck. The mother of a Maine girl killed in 1980 wants the FBI to take over the investigation. Pamela McLean made the comments yesterday on the 30th anniversary of the killing of her 16-year-old daughter, Joyce, who was murdered while jogging in East Millinocket. McLean says she's disappointed there has not been a break in the case in the last 2 years since her daughter's body was exhumed and investigators retrieved what they said were usable DNA samples. A Sebago man shot by Cumberland County Sheriff's deputies nearly 2 years ago was back before a judge today. Douglas Tenzar pleaded no contest to criminal threatening with a dangerous weapon. But under a deal with the court, if Tenzar abided by certain guidelines for a year, he could withdraw that felony plea and plead to a misdemeanor. And that is what happened today. Tenzar received a suspended jail sentence and 1 year of probation. Tenzar lost his arm in the incident. A Westbrook firefighter fired after being arrested on domestic violence charges also appeared before a judge in Cumberland County Court this morning. Richard Doerr is accused of getting into a fight with his estranged wife. Doerr was originally told to have no contact with his wife, but the judge today changed his bail conditions. He is now allowed to text his wife, but only in emergency situations. Students at the University of New England will have a new place to live once the fall semester kicks off in a few weeks. About 300 students, all sophomores, will live in the new dorm, which is across the street from UNE's Biddeford campus. Secaucus Hall cost roughly $26 million. About 2,100 students attend UNE's Biddeford campus, and roughly one-third of them live on the campus. The university says it may build another dorm within the next 5 years. Thank you for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.